Thus, this afternoon, we begin the broadcast with big news that's coming in amid the escalating tension between India and Maldives. The Indian High Commissioner to Maldives are meeting with officials of the Maldives Foreign Ministry. Sources suggest that the meet is over the withdrawal of Indian troops from Maldives. The removal of the India troops had been a poll promise, remember, of the president, and he had discussed the same with Prime Minister Modi on the sidelines of COP28. Now, the island nation has a small deployment of Indian troops stationed in Maldives, whose primary objective is the upkeep of Dhruv helicopters and rescue boats gifted by India. Let me go across to my colleague Rishabh, joining me on that breaking development. Rishabh, good afternoon. What is it that we know so far about this meet, and essentially also help us better understand this move?
Well, definitely. If you see the photos that have been released in the Maldivian media, one thing is clear that this meeting is actually happening about a lot of bilateral issues. The High Commissioner himself is there. Officials from the Indian High Commission are there. The naval attaché, who is posted in Male with the Indian High Commission, is also present in the meeting. So amid a lot of bilateral issues, the photos clearly suggest that the issue of withdrawal of Indian troops from Maldives is one of the key issues that is going to be discussed in this meeting. The sources suggest that this meeting has just begun and will end in a couple of hours, is what we are given to understand. We do expect an official release from the Maldivian Foreign Ministry about the meeting as well. Remember, since President Mizuzu has come to power, he has been stressing on removal of Indian officials, Indian troops from Maldives. There are about 85 to 90 Indian troops who are majorly and primarily there only to maintain the Dhruv helicopters and the rescue boats that India has gifted to Maldives for search and rescue operations, given the topography of the island country. Apart from that, remember, be it when Minister Rizizu was there for the overtaking of the new government, or for that matter in Dubai on the sidelines of COP28, President Mizizu has always put forward his demand to withdraw Indian troops. And see, these demands are not new. There have been such demands from PNC since 2013. But by the time back then, things could materialize. The government changed, and MDP, the Maldivian Democratic Party, actually went ahead and pushed the deadline for the removal of troops to a later date. But since PNC has come to power, and remember, PNC has come to power on the planks of India Out campaign, where President Mizizu and his party do believe that India cannot be a country that can interfere with Maldives. While on the other hand, India has been very clear that the troops that are in Maldives are not for any military operation. They are there to assist Maldives and ensure that the helicopters that India has gifted them, the rescue boats that India has gifted them, can be maintained and are ready, operation ready for rescue and search operations. But definitely this has become a big diplomatic row between India and Maldives. And in last 1 week, we have seen how things have escalated. Only yesterday, Mizizu went on to say that we are a small country, but it doesn't give you license to bully us. In a way, not naming India, but attacking India. We have seen a lot of such arguments coming in from Maldives, where India has countered as well.
Right, Rishabh, I appreciate you joining us on the broadcast and getting us all those details as we need to know about this significant development. Of course, we'll keep coming back to you as you get us more inputs, but for the moment, we leave the conversation at that. We're shifting our focus to tell you about the other big